London just built a secret tunnel that will completely change how the city handles waste. For years, raw sewage overflowed into the River Thames every time it rained. But now, a £5 billion super sewer is here to fix it. The Thames Tideway Tunnel is finally complete, and London just got itself a 15.5-mile-long sewer. In this video, we'll see how this underground marvel will stop millions of tons of sewage from poisoning the river, and learn how it was built beneath one of the busiest cities in the world. You won't want to miss the incredible engineering and how they solved a 150-year-old problem that affected millions. Before we flush out all the details of London's mega sewer project, make sure to subscribe for the latest updates on architectural marvels and mega projects from around the world. London has always been a big, busy city. But when it comes to handling its sewage, it was never the best at it. Back in the 1800s, the city was growing fast, but its waste had nowhere to go. Toilets, drains, and even factories dumped everything straight into the River Thames. That included human waste, animal waste, and industrial chemicals. As a result, there were outbreaks of cholera that killed thousands. And in 1858, the smell from the river was so unbearable it literally shut down Parliament. They called it the Great Stink. So, in came Sir Joseph Bazalgette with a plan. He suggested building a sewer system that would carry the city's waste far downstream. By 1875, the job was done. His sewers were a huge success, but for their time only. They were built for a population of 4 million. London has more than doubled since then. It is now home to over 9 million people. That's more than double the pressure on a system that was already a century and a half old. On top of that, the original system combines rainwater and sewage in the same pipes. That might not sound like a problem until it rains. Even just 2 millimetres of rain could overload the whole thing. When that happens, the system has no choice but to release the excess directly into the River Thames. This means around 39 million tonnes of raw sewage and stormwater go into the river every year. The river was supposed to be a symbol of the city, not the place where its waste ends up. It got so bad that London was breaking European pollution laws. And the water turned so toxic that entire fish species were pushed out of their habitats. London's sewage crisis demanded a real solution. But finding the right one wasn't easy. Experts explored many ideas, each with its own strengths and weaknesses. One option was separating the rainwater pipes from the sewage pipes, which is how modern cities do it. Another idea was building small treatment facilities all across the city to handle overflows locally. And some people pushed for greener fixes, like using gardens, green roofs, and porous pavements to soak up more rain naturally. All of those ideas had one thing in common. They sounded good on paper, but in practice, they were either too expensive, too slow, or just would not solve the problem citywide. London streets are full of buildings, utilities, and traffic. Digging everything up to separate pipes would take decades and cause massive disruptions. And treating sewage at dozens of little sites is complicated, hard to manage, and still not enough during heavy storms. So, after years of research, studies, and public consultations, they agreed on a single bold solution, a super sewer. They decided to build a new tunnel that would intercept the overflow before it reached the river. A backup system, but on a massive scale. The idea became the Thames Tideway Tunnel. The final decision was that the tunnel would stretch 15.5 miles from Acton in the west to Abbey Mills in the east. It would be 7.2 metres wide, which is about as wide as 3 London double-decker buses side by side, and would run deep between 30 to 70 metres underground, depending on the location. They decided to connect this tunnel to the old system at 21 different points across the city. That means whenever the old sewers would overflow, instead of dumping into the river, the waste would get diverted into the new tunnel. From there, it would flow to a massive treatment plant in Bicton, far downstream. It was planned that the tunnel would handle up to 1.6 million cubic metres of overflow, which is about 2,200 Olympic swimming pools of sewage. After years of planning and approvals, the big moment finally arrived, and in 2016, construction officially began. Building a tunnel under one of the busiest cities in the world is not exactly a walk in the park. Construction officially started at 24 different sites across London. And we're not talking about small fenced-off patches. Some of these sites had shafts as wide as the dome of St Paul's Cathedral. To dig a tunnel to desired specifications, you need the heaviest machinery that is out there. And that's why they used huge tunnel boring machines. Six massive tunnel boring machines were custom built for this job. And the cool thing is that they were not just labelled Machine 1 or Drill A. They were named after successful women from British history, like engineer Rachel Parsons and Dr. Selina Fox. In 2016, each machine started drilling through dense London clay, sucking out the debris and lining the tunnel with precast concrete segments as they move forward. These machines worked 24/7, crawling slowly beneath streets, buildings, and even the River Thames itself. While Londoners carried on above ground, deep below them, teams of engineers and workers were coordinating every move, making sure nothing cracked, collapsed, or disrupted the city's foundations. And let's talk about the dirt. This project removed nearly 4 million tons of soil and rock. That's enough to fill Wembley Stadium four times over. But instead of clogging up roads with dump trucks, they did something smart. Most of the material was transported out using the river. Barges carried it away, helping cut down traffic congestion, noise, and carbon emissions. As the main tunnel progressed, smaller connection tunnels were also being built to link up 21 overflow points across the city. Ventilation systems were installed. Massive shafts were dug to bring the waste down into the tunnel. Every part had to be aligned perfectly because a few centimetres off would have failed the entire system. The whole thing took almost a decade to complete. The timeline is justified as they did not have to just dig a hole, they had to build a reliable sewage system that could serve London for the next 100 years. By 2024, the tunnelling was done, and the final connections were being wrapped up. Then in early 2025, the Thames Tideway Tunnel was finally declared fully operational. We all know no project this big gets built without a little controversy, and the Thames Tideway Tunnel had its fair share. But let's start with the good stuff. How is this project going to impact London? Environmentally, the tunnel is a massive upgrade. Before this, all that sewage and stormwater would spill into the Thames. Just a bit of rain and the river turned into a toxic soup. Now, with the new tunnel catching all that overflow, it is expected to cut those spills by 95%, which is huge. That means cleaner water, safer habitats, and a serious boost to biodiversity. Fish populations are expected to recover, and wildlife that could not survive in the polluted water might finally start coming back. For humans, the river is becoming safer for rowing, boating, and even for those brave enough, splashing around near the banks. Socially, it is bringing some surprising wins too. As part of the project, Tideway created over a hectare of new public spaces across the city. Parks, walkways and riverfront areas have been opened up or improved to give Londoners better access to the water. But of course, there have been some controversies. A lot of people were not thrilled about footing the bill. Thames Water customers had to help cover the £5 billion cost through a surcharge on their water bills. At one point, the added cost was expected to reach £80 a year, though it eventually settled close to £20 to £25. Then there was the issue of space. Some construction sites took over parks and riverfront areas during the build. King Edward Memorial Park, for example, became a major flashpoint. Residents were furious about the noise and disruption. Tideway eventually adjusted its plans and promised to improve the park afterward, but the tension was real at that point. And let's not forget the critics who said London should have gone greener with more natural drainage, more green roofs and less concrete. It was a fair point. But in the end, the city went with what could work fast and handle the sheer volume. Like it or not, this tunnel was built to solve a 150-year-old problem. And now, it finally has. To sum it up, the Thames Tideway Tunnel is a monumental project and a massive investment in the city's future. While there were debates about the cost and the environmental impact, there's no denying its importance. Personally, I believe it was the right move. London had no choice but to act to protect the river and the millions of people who depend on it. But what do you think? Do you think the super sewer was the best solution for London's sewage crisis? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. And if you're into architecture, design and construction projects like this one, be sure to check out our other videos and subscribe for more incredible stories from around the world. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.